Good evening, guys. It is wonderful to be back here. Here we are for a fun weekend celebrating the good stuff from birthdays and others. We'll get to some Jurassic Park here very shortly, starting off with that tonight. Take a look at some other games, some other good things in the mix for tonight. So we'll check it out. We'll be lovely. Got a new story today and other things. We're going to take a look, see it, and it'll all be great. So here we are, guys. Welcome on back. Subathon continues. Fun birthday week. Thank you once more to our lovely three champions subscribers so far. We got Zoogly. We've got Maximilis O'Reilly gifting to Marshmallowfont, and we've got Moog all in here supporting in a great time for the lovely birthday weekend and Subathon that is continuing right here, right now. Tomorrow morning, got a rehearsal, have a Messiah on Sunday night. Should be pretty free for Sub-Saturday fun. We'll check it out. We'll all be lovely. We'll have an excellent time of it, so let's focus on great things positively and carrying onward. So welcome back. A fun time we're celebrating here. Our fun things here. We got a Century Age of Ashes. Want to take a look at? We got the new dragon knighting as well for our celebration there. And the King Dragon Knight title for a great time. So we've got that just same as in our Discord. You can take a look at that. And the lovely knighting that worked out so well. So let's take a little quick look here. We've got Century Age of Ashes came out earlier this month. I kind of bypassed without me noticing it, so that was really fast, but we'll get to it soon, and that will be lovely, fantastic stuff. And we do have here in the Discord, you see the King Dragon Knight roll at the top there, so we've now made it official. It's an official knighting and title, so that was lovely and great fun. And all looking good. So Jurassic Park here in a moment. I was taking a look here earlier if this would be fun to play on stream. I used to play this game for 10 years ago or such. It was fun. A powder game. It was a physics simulation game, so you can see a little of that. Just a quick minute here. I was playing around with some of the things. It's pretty fun. Pretty cool. I've enjoyed it here and there over the years, you know, so it's fun to come back to it now and then. But just a fun, you know, little game. Pretty interesting. Forgot what this was. What did I make that out of? Is that ice? Yeah, it must be ice. Yeah, there it goes. Super balls and all these fun characters. So it's a fun little flash game type to play now and then. We'll get to it again at some point. Hopefully. Alrighty, looking good for now, guys. Yeah, there's all sorts of creative fun things to play with it. We'll take a look at that another time. Alright. For now, though, as said, yeah, we'll look forward to install this overnight, hopefully Century Age of Ashes. And we got several good updates here, other things. And on the bright side here, guys, frame drop is looking great. We're still at 0% this whole time, so I guess we're really optimal frames. I'm not going to mess with that. No need to stream test. We'll thank some champions more individually later. But yeah, I'm going to go and install this, the free version. I think you just get other things here. If you buy them, not many reviews so far, not many players, what I can tell. Let's take a look at its initial release. Yeah, it got a nice 7,000 reviews. So yeah, we'll check it out. And yeah, we've been excited for it since a long time now. We reviewed this, we played it for free back there, so I don't know how long ago, but quite a good bit. these new things. So it's July. Yeah, July, we play this in March. So it's been close to a whole year. A lot of anticipation for that. Get back to it soon. We got some new Phasma updates. The new DLC for Hunt already. We've got so many DLCs coming. Dying Light, Hellraid, other stuff. We got more How Was Fun last time. We played a bit of that on Tuesday. So yeah, we'll get some other ones soon. Baldur's Gate action, all the rest. So we'll check it out. Should be set for now. I went ahead and updated Pinball and Hunt tonight. So you can play some Pinball again. And Hunt is ready to go. So we'll see about all that. Looking good, looking fine. Make sure this stream is up to now. I think this thumbnail isn't really accurate. But as long as we have that purple streaming, I believe we're all set. So we'll make sure we're good for now. Get some other stuff here very shortly. And go into our champions. Let's start off with some good Jurassic Park then. Have a lovely time with that. But I have a new Christmas story here, a Tiny Tim Christmas such. We'll go ahead and practice for that because that will be our Zoom selection. And you guys get to see it here. And since I'm not going to be streaming the Zoom this time, I'll go ahead and record it. But we'll not be streaming it live this time because it does affect the slowness a bit. And since I am the very final piece, I want it to run smoothly and fine, finishing out the whole program. So I don't want there to be any internet issues for that. So just go in stream, get ready, practice playing on stream, and I can show you guys any highlights or such from the Zoom show later, or you can always just watch it on live on the Facebook too. So that is good for now. Go ahead and get started, little Jurassic Park. We shall be set, no clipboard. And, looking good for now. Keep that in the background. Yeah, it is updating now, so I know the stream is all working fine. Let's go and get to our Jurassic Park. Hope to have some fun chats tonight, some fun community fun. Thank you at least once more to Zoogly, Leaders in Prime on Tuesday for our birthday party fun. That was a fun mobile stream. Thanks to Mo for coming in and chatting there live on the birthday stream fun. We'll be exporting all that tonight as well. Let's just give him one more shout out here because that was very awesome of him to actually come in and chat for our mobile stream of the castle show. And ran out of battery about halfway before the real fighting and epic stuff started, so I'll know a little better for next time if I want to stream the entire show. Just got to plan out a little better because, yeah, it does go through that battery really fast. Cannot last more than a couple hours, so I'm going to use that portable charger, make sure it's charged before I start. And I did my best. I used the portable charger, though, really beforehand, so, and in the car, so I should just plug it into the car and, you know, prioritize the stream. So we at least got a good amount, though, solid couple hours, and it was fun, birthday fun. Got the knighting ceremony, had fun with mom and friend, and it was all great. So family fun, we can carry on the good stuff. And that is it. Whoop. That is looking good for now, so that works good, all looking fine. Let's carry on for now, guys. Some good Jurassic Park. And go from there. Alrighty. So let's see where we left off here in the lovely Jurassic adventure, shall we? Okay. We have the sixth or such control chapter we're on right now. And yeah, we're reading in the daylight lately. Been getting used to that. It's nice. Tim picked up his goggles as Grant grabbed both the children's hands and began to run. So the Tyrannosaur is after them again now, basically. And I have to run for survival. Looking good for now, though. Welcome on back, Dragon's Roost. Fun weekend ahead, and should hopefully be set for a good full weekend. December streams next week as well. We'll start off the 12 days to Christmas or such. After Subathon's ends, we'll definitely go at least Saturday, maybe Sunday as well. We'll see how it works out, but thank you to those three Dragon Champions making it special. We'll get some few extra streams here, some extra time, whatever we can work out on the schedule. So, little spoon over her rehearsal last night. This one gets a new story tonight, Tiny Tim as well. So, welcome back. Here we are to the next chapter, Control. And we're looking fine, frame drop, and all the rest. So, let's hope that keeps up. Looking set. And we can carry on. Okay. There we go. In the night, the compies scurried along the side of the road. Harding's jeep followed a short distance behind. Ellie pointed farther up the road. Is that a light? Could be, Harding said. Looks almost like headlights. The radio suddenly hummed and crackled. They heard John Arnold say, "You there?" "Ah, there he is," Harding said. "Finally." He pressed the button. "Yes, John, we're here. We're near the river, following the compies. It's quite interesting." More crackling. Then, "Eat your car." "What did he say?" Gennaro said. "Something about a car," Ellie said. At Grant's Dig in Montana, Ellie was the one who operated the radio phone. After years of experience, she had become skilled at picking up garbled transmissions. "I think he said he needs your car." Harding pressed the button. "John, are you there? We can't read you very well. John?" There was a flash of lightning, followed by a long sizzle of radio static, then Arnold's tense voice. "We're 1 mile north of the Hipsey paddock, near the river, following some compies." "No, damn, well, get back here. Ow!" "Sounds like he's got a problem," Ellie said, frowning. There was no mistaking the tension in his voice. "Maybe we should go back." Harding shrugged. "John's frequently got a problem. You know how engineers are. They want everything to go by the book." He pressed the button on the radio. "John, say again, please." More crackling. More static. The loud crash of lightning, then, "Muldoo, need your car. Ow." Gennaro frowned. "Is he saying Muldoo needs our car?" "That's what it sounds like," Ellie said. "Well, that doesn't make any sense," Harding said. "Other, stuck, Muldoon wants car." "I get it," Ellie said. "The other cars are stuck on the road in the storm, and Muldoon wants to get them." Harding shrugged. "Why doesn't Muldoon take the other car?" He pushed the radio button. "John, tell Muldoon to take the other car. It's in the garage." The radio crackled. "Not, listen, crazy bastards, car." Harding pressed the radio button. "I said it's in the garage, John." "The car is in the garage." More static. "Edry has one. "I'm afraid this isn't getting us anywhere," Harding said. "All right, John. We're coming in now." He turned the radio off and turned the car around. "I just wish I understood what the urgency is." Harding put the jeep in gear and they rumbled down the road in the darkness. It was another 10 minutes before they saw the welcoming lights of Safari Lodge. And as Harding pulled to a stop in front of the visitor center, they saw Muldoon coming toward them. He was shouting and waving his arms. "God damn it, Arnold, you son of a bitch! God damn it, get this park back on track! Now! Get my grandkids back here! Now!" John Hammond stood in the control room, screaming and stamping his little feet. He had been carrying on this way for the last 2 minutes while Henry Wu stood in the corner, looking stunned. "Well, Mr. Hammond," Arnold said, "Muldoon's on his way out right now to do exactly that." Arnold turned away and lit another cigarette. Hammond was like every other management guy Arnold had ever seen, whether it was Disney or the Navy. Management guys always behaved the same. They never understood the technical issues, and they thought that screaming was the way to make things happen. And maybe it was, if you were shouting at your secretaries to get you a limousine. But screaming didn't make any difference at all to the problems that Arnold now faced. The computer didn't care if it was screamed at. The network didn't care if it was screamed at. Technical systems were completely indifferent to all the explosive human emotion. If anything, screaming was counterproductive, because Arnold now faced the virtual certainty that Nedry wasn't coming back, which meant that Arnold himself had to go into the computer code and try to figure out what had gone wrong. It was going to be a painstaking job. He needed to be calm and careful. "Why don't you go downstairs to the cafeteria," Arnold said, "get a cup of coffee." We'll call you when we have more news. I don't want a Malcolm effect here, Hammond said. Don't worry about a Malcolm effect, Arnold said. Will you let me get to work? God damn you, Hammond said. I'll call you, sir, when I have news from Muldoon, Arnold said. He pushed buttons on his console and saw the familiar control screen change. It's Jurassic Park main modules, collibs, biostats, and other stats, as you can see. More or less. Stats, power, initialize, set main meter, version run, valid meter, next value, set system, etc. Arnold was no longer operating the computer. He had now gone behind the scenes to look at the code, the line-by-line instructions that told the computer how to behave. Arnold was unhappy, aware that the complete Jurassic Park program contained more than 500,000 lines of code. Most of it undocumented, without explanation. Wu came forward. What are you doing, John? Checking the code. By inspection? That'll take forever. Tell me, Arnold said. Tell me. And that is it for that. We are onto the road some point tomorrow, guys. Go ahead and read a little bit of that nice Christmas story we have here. Let me get right back to that. Let me go grab it real quick. And we'll take a look at that, too. Alright, back in a second, guys. Welcome back, Dragon Series. Great weekend of full-time streaming. See you in just a sec. Alrighty, so let's take a little look there. So we have a Tiny Tim children's short story I got today. That will be our Zoom one a week from today. So we have 1 week to prepare. Mm-hmm. Basically a Christmas carol. It's by Dickens. Yeah. Short Christmas story by Charles Dickens, so. Basically, Christmas carol. Alrighty, take a little look here. And yeah, we'll get used to it. It's a few pages long, about 5 minutes. I don't need this last page here. This is just extra information. Just a little biography about Dickens, but yeah, the story itself is pretty quick. Just these two pages, so. Take a look at that. Think we need any Christmas music here in favor of better frames. Let's keep it out of these music stuff, so we'll just do it clean and fine. Maybe practice with some music background later, in the background later, but I think we'll be good for now. Alright, quick little story here. Let's take a look. There was once a man who did not like Christmas. His name was Scrooge. And he was a hard, sour, tempered man of business, intent only on saving and making money, and caring nothing for anyone. He paid the poor, hard-working clerk in his office as little as he could possibly get the work done for, and lived on as little as possible himself, alone in two dismal rooms. He was never merry or comfortable or happy, and he hated other people to be so, and that was the reason why he hated Christmas. Because people will be happy at Christmas, you know, if they possibly can. Well, it was Christmas Eve, a very cold and foggy one, and Mr. Scrooge having given his poor clerk unwilling permission to spend Christmas Day at home, locked up his office and went home himself in a very bad temper. After having taken some gruel as he sat over a miserable fire in his dismal room, he got into bed. He had some wonderful and disagreeable dreams, to which we will leave him, whilst we see how Tiny Tim, the son of his poor clerk, spent Christmas Day. The name of this clerk was Bob Cratchit. He had a wife and five other children beside Tim, who was a weak and delicate little cripple, gentle and patient and loving, with a sweet face of his own, which no one could help looking at. It was Mr. Cratchit's delight to carry his little boy out on his shoulders to see the shops and the people, and today he had taken him to church for the first time. "Whatever has got your precious father and your brother, Tiny Tim?" exclaimed Mrs. Cratchit. "Here's dinner all ready to be dished up. I've never known him so late on Christmas Day before." "Here he is, Mother," cried Belinda. "And here he is," cried the other children as Mr. Cratchit came in, his long comforter hanging 3 feet from under his threadbare coat. For cold as it was, the poor clerk had no top coat. Tiny Tim was perched on his father's shoulder. "And how did Tiny Tim behave?" asked Mr. Cratchit. "As good as gold and better," replied his father. "He told me coming home that he hoped the people in church who saw he was a cripple would be pleased to remember on Christmas Day who it was who made the lame to walk." "Blessed his sweet heart," said the mother in a trembling voice. Dinner was waiting to be dished up. Mrs. Cratchit proudly placed a goose upon the table. Belinda brought in the applesauce and Peter the mashed potatoes. The other children set chairs. Tim's, as usual, close to his father's, and Tim was so excited that he rapped the table with his knife and carried, "Hurrah!" After the goose came the pudding, all ablaze, with its spring of holly in the middle, and was eaten to the last morsel. Then apples and oranges were set upon the table, and a shovelful of chestnuts on the fire, and Mr. Cratchit served round some hot sweet stuff out of a jug as they closed round the fire, and said, "A Merry Christmas to us all, my dears. God bless us."
"God bless us, everyone,"
echoed Tiny Tim, and then they drank to each other's health, and Mr. Scrooge's health, and told stories and sang songs. Now, in one of Mr. Scrooge's dreams on Christmas Eve, a Christmas spirit showed him his clerk's home. He saw them all, heard them drink his health, and he took special note of Tiny Tim himself. How Mr. Scrooge spent Christmas Day, we do not know, but on Christmas night, he had more dreams, and the spirit took him again to his clerk's poor home. Upstairs, the father, with his face hidden in his hands, sat beside a little bed, on which lay a tiny figure, white and still. Tiny Tim died because his father was too poor to give him what was necessary to make him well. "You kept him poor," said the dream spirit to Mr. Scrooge. The father kissed the cold little face on the bed, and went downstairs where the sprays of holly still remained about the humble room, and taking his hat, went out with a wistful glance at the little church in the corner as he shut the door. Mr. Scrooge saw all this, but wonderful to relate, he woke the next morning feeling as if he had never felt in his life before. "Why, I'm as light as a feather, and as happy as an angel, and as merry as a schoolboy," he said to himself. "I hope everybody had a Merry Christmas, and here's a Happy New Year to all the world." Poor Bob Cratchit crept into the office a few minutes late, expecting to be scolded for it. But his master was there with his back to a good fire, and actually smiling, and he shook hands with his clerk, telling him heartily he was going to raise his salary, and asking quite affectionately after Tiny Tim. "And mind you make up a good fire in your room before you set to work, Bob," he said as he closed his own door. Bob could hardly believe his eyes and ears, but it was all true. Such doings as they had on New Year's Day had never been seen before in the Cratchits' home, nor such a turkey as Mr. Scrooge sent them for dinner. Tiny Tim had his share, too, for Tiny Tim did not die. Not a bit of it. Mr. Scrooge was a second Father Tim from that day. He wanted for nothing, and grew up strong and hearty. But Mr. Scrooge loved him, and well he might. For was it not Tiny Tim who had unconsciously, through the Christmas dream spirit, touched his hard heart, and caused him to become a good and happy man? All right, hope you guys enjoyed that. A nice little summary of the Christmas Carol, pretty much from Cratchit's perspective there. Pretty cool. So that was fun, and we will look forward to that a week from now. I'm thinking I may just bring it up on my monitor here so I don't have to look down as much. Can look more at the camera just there on the monitor, but we'll see. We'll practice with both of those, and maybe just read it there next time, see how it looked, and I can watch in the playback VOD. But for now, that is good stuff to start here, guys. We'll get to some hunt at some point. We could start with a few other things tonight. We've got that other Styx games, Master of Shadows such. We have Dishonored, Death of the Outsider to begin as well. So we want to start some of those games for sure. We could play a little pinball, little Wasteland. Lots of good stuff to be had here, so. Some fun bit of stories for now. Pretty cool, pretty fun. Get to other ones shortly. I don't know, I kind of want to beat those golems in Baldur's Gate. Just to freaking get them done in the black pits there. So maybe we should start with some of that actually while we're in. No particular hurry for anything. And we'll see if we get some hunt partners. Or such. So good for now. We could take a look at these golems and maybe look out how to beat them. So that we don't have to fight them ever again, prof. Alright, let's take a little look at that, guys. I think that'll be fun. We haven't played since October. We attempted it last time, this whole 2 months ago. The Black Pits. I want to get back to Siege of Dragonsphere, play that through properly and fully, so. So we shall see.
Come on! Come on! Feast your eyes upon the most marvelous martial magnificence that the Underdark has to offer.
Let's see.
Bailoff, the Entertainer!
Yep, there's the Black Pits, just as we wanted them. Alright, so that was last left off right here. Quick save. See if we can buy a magic item for these golems, and then we're probably gonna have to look up how in the heck you actually beat them, because I've had no success so far. They are so fast, they are so strong. There are so many of them, and they are completely resistant to all attacks. Imeloth, unfortunately, still bugged in the vendor booth here, so we have to have Ashia take over for now. Really enjoy these characters, though. Pretty fun. These are three of my original characters, and I went ahead and did a Talana from her, the Black Pits actual original party, which is originally six of them, but four is good. It's the Baldur's Gate 3 party, anyway, so. But I have I spent all my money here, looks like. Scrolls and stuff, so I might have to reload even earlier before this. I'm gonna go and not save anything for now if I need to reload from before this, or we could also do the tier 2 tier 1 battles. Tier 1 tier 2 tier 3 just to try and get ready for the freaking crazy golems here, though the beholder did recommend that we use magic weapons. We use enchanted weapons as many as possible. These guys are just so hard to beat. I don't know what to do.
While subtlety can be deadly, who doesn't love a good, straightforward beating? And what beating isn't better with bigger
brawlers?
Watch as these brutal behemoths batter their enemies to bloody rubbish.
This is the first time I've really gotten stuck. I have absolutely no idea what to do, just how to counter them. You don't encounter that many in the actual game, so it's pretty much a unique enemy. And just gonna keep trying to figure it out, whatever will work here. But we'll have a fun time of it. In any case, so. We'll see. Oh man, it is a challenging one though. Definitely. So we'll work on it, see what we can do.
What do you think would work, guys?
I don't know what will work here. It's just really challenging. I don't know what level this is either. We'll just have to ask. What that can kill these shambling mounds, shambling mound and clay golems. There's one shambling mound. He is actually the strongest of them. And clay golems, they are all
yes,
pretty damn deadly in their own right. And they stun me or something. I don't know what they do to disable me, basically. Throw an explosion at him, see if that helps.
I am here. What is it? Yes?
Everybody doing something. See how the regular arrow goes. And use her fire arrows. It's freaking
what?
Crazy, though. Just that oil of speed. And yeah, I think you really just need the right weapon or something. Just not effective at anything. The explosion. 11 fire damage, so they can take some damage from fire. That's good, but still, even at pretty low difficulty here. I mean, I could just pop on story mode, but it would be more fun to beat them legitly, you know. Not just have to turn god mode on, basically, to kill them. That's not really fair, so. It would be more satisfying to kill them legitly than if I ever encounter these type of enemies. Again, I know the specific type of, weapons or such that are needed to beat them, but you'll see right now
you rang.
They take very little damage. Just need magic weapons. I don't know, dagger plus one isn't really considered magic.
Yes.
I only have a longsword plus one for her. Bullet plus one
what
for
is
her.
It? What is it?
And
what?
She just has the short sword plus one too.
Get over here!
So I only have so much oil, but I can use it while I have it.
Yep.
She has some magic, but not too much. I did try to conjure that fire limb last time. It didn't seem to really do anything. Maybe the Phantom Blade will work? I don't know. Potion of Freedom, I don't need for now. Let me try the Phantom Blade. It's just hard. It's crazy, guys. But I've been wanting to get back to it, you know, I'm thinking about it. We just have to finish it somehow. It takes forever her to take that oil of speed. That's ridiculous. Oh, man. Takes a minute, so. Trying to get him. Alright, she had the potion. Let's see if the sword plus one does any damage.
Could use a little patching on.
The blade.
So
she's
here.
Using it now. He's almost dead right away. That's not so good.
Go on, then.
He did it for 70 damage.
I'm on it.
I'll turn on story mode as a last resort. I at least want to look up how the heck to beat them first.
It
must be
this.
A solid strategy out there.
Yeah,
we can't do anything against these guys. It's terrible.
Yes.
Really terrible. Let me see if Aura of Despair. Let's get them to be able to be attacked. Yep, her Phantom Blade not doing the trick. Charm Person won't work for them. I only have a few other things for her here. Not gonna save her for long. Didn't even get them low or anything. They're just so resistant. Yeah, there's really no chance here. I just can't hit them. I can't do damage to them. And I can't survive them for more than, like, 5 seconds. Ugh. Yeah, it doesn't even hit them. Just the sword is, like, instant miss. That's so ridiculous. I think magic protection would help against them either. Nope. Really not gonna help. Okay. Alright, let's look up how the heck to defeat the this crazy black pits. Crazy time. And then we can reload a little earlier to actually afford the, yeah, afford the next stuff here. So let me take a look up how the heck to beat them. Okay. Must have something here. Black pits, clay golems. And the steam decussion, of course. Punch my way through with six munch. Any blunt weapon would work. Can't do damage to them because there are no clubs. Plus one. Oh, that plus one's not working, though. Magical blunt weapon. Okay. Huh. So it does have to be blunt. The sharpness is just reflected completely, so that's why I wasn't able to damage them with sharp weapons. Huh. Alright, cool. So now we have a little hint there. He didn't say that. The beholder just said magic weapon. He said nothing whether it was sharp or blunt, so I had no idea, you know, but it does make sense. Same as in Hunt, some enemies are pretty immune to rending damage, while other ones are, you know, weak to the blunt damage. There's the giant. We already took care of that rival party. His advice really wasn't that great.
The simplest advantages are often the most effective. Never enter a battle without an enchanted weapon.
So that's what he says for the golems. It doesn't seem to be very good advice, but I have this extra money. I didn't spend this time because I didn't get a... What did I get that time? I spent it on something. I don't know. I don't really notice what I have. It must have been armor or something subtle like that. But now if I just get the blunt weapons, hopefully we'll have a better chance here. Go ahead and not save anything for now until we get past it. But if I can get some... yeah, maces. There is maces plus ones. That guy was saying he was using clubs for the monk. But we can use maces, I hope, for most of them. Let me see. Mace plus one for Imaloth. There we go. And she can't use it. He can't use it. Alright, so I can only have one mace. That's gonna be tricky. Hopefully it's enough.
What?
Use that potion of speed right away. Let's see if that makes at least a big difference, because it'll make... If I can attack them, it'll work, so... Let's see, now Imla, the main character with the mace, the rest are just basically meat shields. And, maybe she can actually do some damage soon. Take that potion of speed. And use the mace. Plus one. For these specific enemies. The rest really didn't seem to make any difference, so I feel like it's really just not even worth it. But I'll just use them anyway, I guess. Have some armor on her. Potion of speed. Explosions out. Burn myself. And she took the potion. I believe. Yep. And here we go. Still okay, now we're taking crushing damage. See, they had no slashing damage or piercing damage.
What is it?
But now they're actually taking some damage, so that's what we want. Is she still casting armor? I can't tell. Alright. Smash him down, Imaloth. Come on. She should be going faster with that potion of speed.
What?
Definitely took it.
I am here.
This is hard.
Yes.
So we got one almost to halfway. It's kind of a disadvantage I can't put them all on maces, you know. But I can keep them alive for a little while. At least buy her some time. To smash these bastards. Come on. Try that aura. Yep, there he goes. Two already. Already two out. Smash them a lot. Alright, got one. Finally some progress, at least, huh? Some of that fire elemental, so she looks at something. She's mental. Oh yeah, she controls it so she can't actually do anything while she's controlling it, which is weird. But they smash it like nothing, so. Amaloth has her work cut out for her. Oh yeah, shield amulet, let me use that at least. Hopefully some protection. Smash them, come on, there we go. We can trade enough hits. Might get out of this freaking mess. Save the big one for last. I guess he probably has the most health. These underlings. Oh man. Pounding her. I can't get the potions off other people either. That's the annoying thing. Got one potion.
Your life should be mine.
Oh, man. This is pretty rough. Alright. I'll kill him next. Picture of, oh come on. Elixir of health.
Fine.
Potion of freedom. Hurt. Really just stuck. Okay. You see two and the big one.
Your life shall be mine.
Bring more health potions. I guess if I bring enough health potions, I just put them on her because she's the only one who can really fight it anyway. Ugh. So if you had no characters that could use blunt weapons, well, I guess you can always use the club, so maybe look for the club instead of the mace. They'll have something. But see, we at least made some progress. We at least got a couple of them down now. That is way better than four where we couldn't do anything. So at least we're moving in the right direction, but she's not going to make it this time. Can't even hit that big one. I'm pretty sure he's the same as the others. Alright, we'll figure it out. So, now I have an idea. Let me get them all.
Fine.
Clubs. Instead of maces. Wooden clubs. Flail might work too. It is crushing. Yeah, it only has to be crushing damage. So, it doesn't have to be the mace. Where are the clubs? Quarterstaff is also crushing, so. Alright, there's some clubs. Let me get some club. Let me just make sure they can use it. Yep, she can use it, he can use it, she can use it. Wait, cannot use item. Alright, there we go. Make sure she can. Yes. So only the wizard here cannot, which is inconvenient. Not usable by a mage. She just happens to be a mage. That's so funny. There must be some blunt weapon that she can use then. Alright, I'll buy another of those. And maybe something different. Oh yeah, we can just give her a quarter stone. Maybe something not the mace plus one for Imaloth. Let me see. There's no club plus ones, like we read in the forum. The flail could be better. She's one-hand proficiency, but let me see what does more damage. The Morning Star. Can't afford the plus one by barely. Plus two is pretty nice. Mace one seemed pretty decent, though. Oh, Warhammer also works. She has always been one-handed proficiency, though, so probably, well actually she's not in this one yet, so it doesn't really matter. Yeah, she is. Okay, single weapon style, sword and shield style I just did for extra. She doesn't really need a shield, but it wouldn't hurt. But yeah, single weapon style is better. So we'll just go ahead and focus on that. Got this Plate of the Dark. So club work, but we'll probably do a little better. The mace work. I guess we'll just try that again. Alright. More clubs around and a quarterstaff. Quarterstaff for the mage to Lana here. Alright. that, pretty much the best equipped we'll get is one more club. So at least now they can actually do something, you know. Alright, one more club here, I guess. There. Spear. It's also piercing. So we have piercing, crushing, and slashing. Huh? All these different damage types, yeah. Haven't really done much piercing, so that would be fun to try. Actually, someone with a spear. Those are hard to find in most of these games. There's no spears in Skyrim. So that could actually be pretty fun. When we have the optimization for it. Where do those clubs go? How can I use the club? It's not like he only had that many for sale, right? This does not make sense. There it is. I was just bypassing it. I'm sorry. Alright. Club, quarterstaff, and mace plus one. That's pretty much the best chance we're gonna get. We do a new save just for these freaking golems. Now that we're equipped and we have a little extra money for healing potions, I'm gonna give them all to her because it does not seem to work otherwise. Alright, take that oil of speed. We don't really need clarity and all these. Magic protection. Yeah, these guys are just physical enemies. Let's see what else.
I am here, certainly.
Hey, the concoctor says he's become your biggest fan. He's glad you've done so well in the arena. Can I show you some of our new potions?
Alright. Potions, the elixir of health is pretty pricey. Yeah, 300 for just one of those, so it's not worth it to do that. Instead, though, it's one more extra health and cure poison and disease, so that's okay. We'll buy three of those, get that bag of holding, see the dragons, three other stuff. Alright, so now I got 7 healing potions for her. See if these guys can hold their own for a little while. And we'll go ahead and use those explosives anyway, I guess. Silly. Couple explosives for them, she'll do the speed potion. That's pretty much the best we are gonna get, guys, so might as well,
What? Such menial tasks.
Yeah, right over that. I think that's the best we're gonna get. We have the earlier quick save if we still can't beat him, but it should not be that hard, I mean. Now we're at least equipped for it, right? Oh, man. Let's get him. Oh boy.
While some of me can be deadly, who doesn't love a good
Alright, so at least I have a strategy now. We know what works against them.
Watch as these brutal heathens batter their enemies to bloody rubbish.
Try to take out a one of them quickly might be better.
Your concern?
Just focus all the firepower on him.
Potion
of speed. Here we go. Let's see if we can do it. Well, immune to damage. That didn't work. That didn't work at all.
You
salted.
Thought that's supposed to, maybe only he did his fire damage. Alright, well now I know that. The clay golems, yeah, I should have known clay is resistant to fire. But the shambling mound is more earth. Alright, at least now we have the right weapons. Maybe they'll still get it. Let's see.
What?
Damn.
Such menial tasks.
Pretty difficult.
Yes?
Still having a bit of trouble here. This is crazy.
I could use a little on then. Right, what's this then?
Your concern?
They made this one pretty dang tough.
Speaking of salted.
I do not. not get it. I don't get it. It's a tough one, guys. I mean, definitely not straightforward, but still good fun. Get through it eventually. I don't think the explosive potions would make much difference. Don't even attack them. My party. Get a freaking hit in. That'd be nice. Yeah. Too fast. They're really overpoweredly fast. Okay, we finally got one there. That was good.
What is it?
Get another one.
Yes?
You rang. Right, what's this then?
Jeez. Why are they so fast? Pretty ridiculous. She has enough to finish. It only affected him, that's interesting. See if her healing potions pays off, or else we will try again. I don't think I want to turn into story mode for anything in this game, it's just so cheap. I guess this is the challenge, and we shall overcome it. However many times it takes, you know. We shall get it, though. The big boy left right after we hit this one. There it is. Alright, kill this bastard. He's really hard to hit though. I don't understand why it's different for him. Weapon ineffective. So what damage does he take then? Neither of the... I have to look this up again. Neither of the damage types have any effect, so maybe that one is piercing. Oh man. That is insane. Shambling mounds appear to be heaps of rotting vegetation. They're actually an intelligent form of life. They build their own race while they count as elementals on the earth type. Let me see. What in the heck are they weak to? Oh. Resistant to everything. Oh man, that is so crazy. Saving throws, damage resistances. They do have a lot of elemental resistances. But what physical resistances? Siege of Dragon Spear. 10 crushing damage may be dealt. Entangle the target. Shambling Mound's attack counts as being made. Oh, doesn't say what they're weak to, though. Is there weakness? resistance. Resistance to all these things. If it's only piercing damage, I'm kind of screwed because I didn't bring that spear, so I should have bought that one gold spear. Maybe that would work. Must have something that can damage it. Can be hurt by magical weapons, but already those with an enchantment. Only the moves faster with the party. Stay undefeated during a history of violent beating. The shambling mound in the black pits will stay until defeated during a history of violent people. What? it attacks hurt party members. Only be hurt by magical weapons. But it has to be at least two? I don't have anything that powerful. No particular resistance or immunities. I just have to keep trying other stuff then. This is ridiculous. Oh my goodness, man. Why is this so ridiculous, guys? It's the last one. Save him for last, and I just have nothing that can hurt him. And I can't take any of the dead party member stuff, which is unfortunate in itself. They had extra things, but should have enough for the job here. So, weapon ineffective.
Yes? What is it?
For crushing, for slashing.
Your life should be mine.
Only thing I have left is missiles, then the darts. I have 9 of those.
A simple matter.
Still unaffected. Let me try fists then, honestly. Unarmed. Still unaffected. This is so ridiculous. We come down to the last one. We just have nothing to beat him with. I don't believe it. It must be piercing then. It said, yeah, it can be damaged by magical plus 2. How am I going to afford a plus 2 anything? And it would probably have to be crushing at that. Yeah, plus 1. Not doing the job. That's not fair, man. Just nothing I can do against him. Oh, man. That's not for missiles, so it's not really helpful for regular things. Weapon ineffective.
I am wounded.
That sucks. We finally made some progress, all the clay golems. But this bastard. There's no way I could get that much fire for him. Sucks. There's nothing else to be done with. Nothing else to be done. Have to save it for a plus 2 magic, I guess. We should probably kill him first next time. Ugh. Just doesn't do anything, so. Yep. Really? So we'll reload. We have that other golem saving this one with 2,000. Is there any plus 2s that are cheap enough? Hardly golem, yeah. That might work. Oh, this is so frustrating. There are no records of this weapon's creator. Nevertheless, its existence can be tracked back among thieves and murderers to before Dala Reckoning. Its blackened blade was apparently forged from the arcane metals of an iron golem, giving the weapon an appearance as dark as its history. So that's piercing, even though it's hard of the golem, probably won't work against the golem. Quarterstaff plus 2 for 3,000. Rashard's Talon. It's relatively cheap. Maybe I should buy this one. So plus 2, maybe it'll do the job. But it's slashing, so probably not. I mean, it seemed like it had to be any plus 2 to damage him, but they do seem to be better blunt than piercing. Longsword plus 2 is twice the amount of money I have. Bastion sword even more. Two-handed sword, spear. Yeah, I could try the spear, I guess. It's a nice looking spear. Well, and upgraded. See if Imeloth would like to use that. Maybe that'll get the job done. I mean, they were fine for all the others. We just have to kill that main one, so. Let me try out the spear. See if we can actually kill that main one or not. And I do need to buy all their clubs again, so let me do that. Alright, quarterstaff. Two clubs. Pretty crazy, guys. Not have this much of a adaptable situation as this. We really have to stretch to overcome it. Alright, we'll try that out. Remember to use the fire stuff for just the big one, and then maybe we can kill him right away. And I think you can take the potions here, right? Before you actually go in. Better. Maybe a little better. I can buy it with my remaining money.
I am. It is done.
Hey, the Concordor says he's become your biggest fan. He played. He done so well in the arena. Can I show you some of our new potions?
If I take it now, it should last for the battle, which is basically teleporting right then, so.
Hey! The Concordor says he's become your biggest fan! Yes. He's glad you've done so well in the arena! Can I show you some of our new potions?
It is done.
I think that works. Alright, let's try it. Take those buffs immediately before it'll stay, right? I think so. All right, see if we can finally get through this nonsense, guys. Glory of the Dragon's Roost. Hopefully the spear will do the trick. Otherwise, I don't know what else to do.
Yes.
Really out of options. Oh, man. Kill him first.
I am here.
You rang.
What is it?
Your concern?
Go on, then.
Yes?
Is the piercing working? Yes! Piercing is the pretty much the only damage type I didn't try, so. Thankfully, it is working.
It's
messed up.
Right,
I am. What?
Not for long. Got him. What? Okay, now we're getting somewhere, guys. Here. Now we are getting somewhere.
Yes?
There we go. one. Oh.
What is it?
Should I step time?
A simple matter.
Extra support. Oh. Okay, now he's immune to piercing. So only the Shambler. Oh, I forgot to get him. Forgot to get an extra mace for her. Alright, Ashley, well, you're still alive. Pass that over, Elise. Freaking try. Oh, man. That longsword proficiency, so. Matter.
What? Fine.
Come on, just break it down.
Yes? Certainly.
Dramatic orbs and Baldur's Gate.
Yes.
This one's not
a
quite
simple matter. I am certainly.
There's too much to handle. Fire elemental not gonna matter. Spider spawn can be fun. Try that, I guess.
Yes. I must have aid.
The spider. Wow. Fight, spider.
What is it?
Damn. It's too much. I killed these guys last time, just not the other one. What's happening this time? Ugh. I guess the mace really was effective. These guys, but I can't really afford the spear and the mace. But then again, the only reason I killed the Shambler was because it is a plus two, so I have to get the. I can't believe these guys are so tough now. What is happening? Weapon ineffective. It's crushing. How can it be ineffective? This is just the worst level I have seen. Pretty much any game like this. So the mace work because it was enchanted, I guess. Nothing else will work against these guys. That is so insane. Still immune to that. Spear too, so there's nothing else to do again. I'm just stuck because I didn't save up enough money. So I better keep doing tier 2 battles or tier 3 battles, then get the spear. If I can afford the spear again, then I'll have both of what I need to finally kill these bastards. Oh man. Why is this so ridiculous? I can't believe it. Alright, let's see what they give me for tier 3 battle, get some money, see if that's even worth it to
what?
Do.
A simple matter.
So I need both those extra magic weapons just to be able to.
Didn't get it quite right the first time, did we? Alright, which battle are you going to attack?
Swamped. Alright, so maybe we get extra money from this. We can afford the spear, get both of them. Nothing up to that point was as bad, so if we can just do this a couple times, we'll have enough money. Ugh.
Tell me. Which even do you enjoy the most? A foul set of clawed hands grasping each other? Or the painful, dissolving juices of slime creeping into your head? Wait, don't answer. You
is this the one with the blobs I need fire damage to kill? They give you such unique enemies to really resist. Yeah, these were the fire ones. I should have known. I have to get them low enough to kill them with fire.
Yes.
But I do have fire arrows, so it should be
alright. I am here.
Should be alright for now.
Yes.
Just finish them with fire.
Go on then. Get over here.
Your concern?
What is it? A simple matter. Your life shall be mine.
Yes, indeed. I am here.
That.
What?
Switch to these fire arrows. This guy. Oh, he regenerates. You see that? Those good guys.
Your concern?
You rang.
What? Your light
should be. I could use a little patching up.
Of course.
Go on then.
Hold it. I could use a little patching up.
Fucking insane.
Speak.
Oh yeah, these guys are poison too.
I'm on it.
What about that?
Get away.
Well, that worked.
Yes.
Somehow. Maybe because it was magic? I don't know. Oh wait, fire arrow, yeah.
Okay. I am here. Indeed.
Burning hands. They get poisoned to death. Okay.
What is it? What?
Out to the trip.
Your concern?
God. He's slowed. Oh, hopefully we got a decent amount of money for this. It doesn't really matter their health, so... Okay. Got it. They just keep splitting in multiple ones, that's annoying.
Oh, this is no fun.
Yes. Alright. Is that enough money for that spear? I have to keep doing it. Oh man, 4,000.
Yeah, fine.
So if I can afford that spear now, I'm thinking we should be okay with the mace and the spear. Oh. That would be the idea. Yep, spear plus two. Buy a few extra things here. I will have the mace for the golems, the spear for the big one. Really hope that is enough. These things just not working. It is so confusing. They work sometimes, they don't other time. What am I supposed to do? It really just lies on Emeloth to finish the job. Freaking madness. Absolute madness. I'm not gonna miss this mission. This specific challenge will not be missed. All right. I have more than I had the first save here, so let me save golems again. I don't know what else to get here. Potions.
Hey! The Concordia says he's become your biggest fan!
Keep them alive. I don't really need anything as long as
Emeloth
can make it work. So let me get extra potions for her. Ooh, 27 health points. That's kind of nice. Alright, so now she has plenty of health. That will last her. So those damn explosives doesn't really make any difference. Just try to get in there, get it done. Hopefully. See if they can see it through. What else can be done at this point?
What?
I've already done, but hopefully having both these weapons now, the plus one and the plus two, that will be enough to finish the job. Let's see.
What is it? A simple matter.
Ah, you have returned!
Are you ready? Oh, man. Are pretty crazy.
While some of you can, who doesn't love a good, straightforward and what's treating even better with bigger brawling?
What?
Watch as these brutal minions batter their enemies to bloody rubbish.
They all get slowed from. They're still slowed from something.
What is it?
Going for him first, because he was the one that originally gave me the most trouble.
Your life should be mine.
I am here.
Just encircling.
Yes.
Ridiculously.
Fine.
Try the fire.
Go on, man.
He's getting slow.
What's this then?
Oh, that one. Nice. All right, now it's a mace. Can I actually damage them? Come on.
What is it?
I could use a little patching up. Right, what's this then?
Yes? You're
you
lying.
Right, what's this then?
I am wounded. What?
Crazy.
A simple matter.
Absolutely crazy. We'll try the arrow plus two.
Go on, man. Sword.
Yes?
Speak.
Yes?
That worked.
You rang.
He's dead, yep. Level up. Not gonna matter now. I gave him some health back. That's funny.
Sorted.
That's pretty funny. What is going on here?
What is it? You're alive.
Alright, there we go. 22 crushing damage. She falls.
I am here.
These other bastards.
What?
That's it. Finally, we can damage both of the monsters here. So crazy.
Yes? Yes?
Gladiator Reno will host and fun, but this is just so challenging, man. So good to finally finish it.
I am indeed.
There's plenty of heals.
What?
There we go. Time to meet the freaking fates. Is that turning undead? Yeah, you need to turn undead. Finish them off in one. Come on. The last two. Party island. There we go. One more to finally finish. Get some big hype in the chat to finally finish the golem bastards. Oh man. God, jeez. That was too much.
What a despicable display of enchanted weapons. It's almost as if someone gave her advice. Was it you, Najin?
There we go. Oh man. Break after that. I'll be just back in a second. That was crazy. We finally got it though. Good stuff. Alright, moving forward. Alright, so, finally got that combination of piercing spear for all the giant one and the crushing, but it had to be the right magical properties, at least plus one, plus two. I am glad to finally be done with that, though. See if there's any other crazy curveballs like that moving forward. That was quite a bit, though, guys. Yeah, very glad to be done with that. Pretty crazy.
If anyone counsels them, I assure you, it is not I.
Okay, no, my master, I obey at your every command. Sorry. Alt-tabbing not good for this game. It basically just runs in the background, so I'll try to avoid that. For the most part, okay. Whew! So great to finally be done with that madness. That was so messed up.
Go on, man.
I don't know why Emoth got stuck in the booth here, but I can work around it. Alright, another level up for Mar. This one didn't count or something. Level 9, 11. Okay. Finally took care of that, you guys. Wow. Alright, get back to the regular weapons. We'll keep those as extra. That was something, alright. Oh man. Still most proficient in longsword, but now I've got all these other. The spear, pretty cool, but still, this is the most effective weapon for it, as you can see from the stats there on the right. Proficiency makes quite the difference. Alright, save after that. Yep, finally, golems complete. And it is a new day. Maloth in the black pits. Alright, anything to say, all these guys?
What fine?
Much as I fie on you. Obviously, he has chosen opponents with subtle weaknesses, invisible to the eyes of the audience. How else could you have come so far with your obviously limited abilities?
Let's see what's next. Well, let's take a look.
Your pathetic magisk is no match for the might of Ildjotun. Come out of your hole and face me.
Hogarl. Older.
I'm prepared to face you next minute. Winter is coming.
Winter.
And you must be prepared for its frozen.
Alright, so some ice enemies or other. Winter is coming. Let's see. Get our fire and blood counter. Alright, so maybe more fire things. We got 10,000 from those freaking golems, so got that hard save. We're good for now. Get a few other things here. Probably just get better gear for everyone, but I'm pretty happy with what they have. Pretty good. This guy always been here. Yeah, okay. Fire giant strength. Want some more. Cold resistance, that could be good. Yep. We'll try it the one time. Let's see if it's worth it or not. Okay. Basilisk. Petrification. Strength 18. For the fun of it. Alright. Should be relatively well equipped. Her strength already at,
what is it?
18. So we don't really need that. Fire arrows wouldn't hurt.
Such menial tasks. What fine?
Let's see here. Arrow of fire plus two. let's give it a try, I guess. See what we are up against. Get another cloak for her, maybe. Pretty helpful things, but pretty dang expensive. Alright, we'll see what we're up against. We can always buy more. Reload, of course.
Ah, you have returned!
Are you ready to spill blood on the arena floor?
What?
Take those potions. Too far away.
Such menial tasks. Yes. A simple matter.
Of course. That last for 2 hours. Okay, let's try.
Ah, you have returned.
Carrying on. Crazy good stuff. To this pit.
From the uttermost reaches of the Great Glacier, I bring you a frozen treat unlike any you have enjoyed before. Thrill to the fearsome ferocity of these frosty foes.
All right, frost trolls or something. Let's see. Looking fine, looking good. No need for stream test for now. Let's carry on. Okay. What have we got here? Those golems, it can't be anything much worse. Oh boy. These are ice salamanders. Definitely have not seen these before. Cleric. Should probably take care of him then.
Yes. What? Fine.
It's the middle to use my aura here. Let's try that out.
You right.
A little bit crazy though.
Yes.
There it is. Straight for the cleric, perhaps. Be smart.
Go on then.
Yes?
That potion of genius. Let's melt some salamanders, shall we?
What is it?
Whoops. Making it rain, blizzard there. That's.
What is it?
I am here.
Let's see, try versus. Take out this spellcaster. Uh-oh, she did get slept, so I should have used that magic protection. More fun to fight, though they're not just crazy, they're just pretty strong. Generally strong. So. Could help. I mean, fire versus ice. Mother. Holy mess.
Go on, man. I'm on it.
Still trying to kill him on the way. Oh yeah. Yeah, they both died in one attack. It was down in one of once. Weapon in effect. Oh, his weapon in effect. Nice. Setting him down, almost there. Well, I'm really the strong carry for the team. Quite the defense. More blizzard. Blizzard's still up, huh? Still plenty of a challenge. And yeah, that frost resistance kept them alive probably quite a bit more than otherwise. Oh man. That's pretty good. How about that, guys? Got it yet again. There it is. Oh, man. Pretty freaking intense.
A simple matter.
Whew. That got a level up for it. Done.
What? Fine.
Oh man.
Yes, such menial tasks.
Yep, that one was definitely challenging, but it wasn't.
I will shatter this conjurike of yours, Baloth. I will watch it burn while I look upon your bones.
Shook the whole house. That was crazy. Huh? What are you doing? That's funny.
Are you prepared to face your next match?
Let's see.
No less powerful than ice is
fire.
Protect yourselves or prepare to burn.
Alright. From ice to fire and another 10,000 or so. There's plenty of things. Noble Vampire with the raid, or host, I guess. Raid doesn't work. Thank you, Noble. How are you guys doing? Thank you for that, host. Good to see you. Having some birthday fun here. Good weekend, good fun. Oh, that looks interesting. is signing some things. Good to see you. We're getting some good Baldur's Gate action here tonight. I'll play the proper raid for you if you'd like to see that. It says that it... Oh, there it is. Thank you for the raid, Noble. Welcome in. Everybody, good to see ya. And, yeah, triple fall if you like. Dragon's Roost here, full-time streaming, 1st of December. Some fun stuff here. Baldur's Gate, we carry on from birthday weekend is our first Subathon as well. How you doing, Noble? You're playing some Phasmophobia. Excited to get some more of that myself. Horror Tuesdays. Saw that update for some cursed items. That was cool, huh? Been better, can't live on Phasma anymore. And happy B-Day. Thank you, Noble. Appreciate it. Yeah, as last time I played on that nightmare mode, it is much harder to survive than it used to be. Not that it was ever, like, too easy, but yeah, it's definitely... They're making it more and more interesting. It's some really good updates. I saw some people didn't like the game. They had left some bad reviews for it, but my experience, it's been fun. I played it for over a year now. Actually, my birthday last year, I was playing it. I made a post for ghost hunting on my birthday with the Ghostbusters song. But yes, welcome in there, Noble. Glad you had a fun time here. Welcome back to the Dragon's Roost. Lovely to see you. Your first chat here in quite a while. Let's see. Your last time we saw you was June. Is that correct? Looks like no. Yeah, last time was June. Or, no, August. August, so we seen you 2 months ago. 2 months to Christmas. No. 4 months. We saw you 4 months ago. Welcome back. Lots of good streams to me, son. Oh, thank you for the cheer, my friend. Much appreciated. Makes you want to cry. Well, it's all right. You know, it's part of the fun of the cheer. All those new ghosts and such, super interesting. I'm sorry it slipped out of the glass there. I'm going to empty this tomorrow, I think, sub-Saturday. Thank you for the cheer there. Let's see if we can get it to land in the tip jar properly. Yes, welcome on in, Raiders. Welcome to the Dragon Tree. Some fun adventures here. No, it just does not want to land in the jar. I'm sorry. I could maybe put that in first thing tomorrow or such, but... Oh, we got it in. Nice. There you go. Yeah, I don't worry about math. It's ridiculous. Not important. This is one Baldur's Gate tonight. So we finally defeated the clay golems. We read some good Jurassic Park. We read a Christmas story. We're having a fun time here. Big variety. Maybe some hunting a little bit. Excited back to Dead by Daylight and Phasmo soon as well. Maybe Death of the Outsiders, some Styx Master Shadows gonna install tonight. Century Age of Ashes, have you heard of that game, Noble? Thank you for the cheer, my friend. It's a fun, rebel. Yeah, it's a fun, dragon riding game. We're gonna try that out tomorrow, hopefully.
Hey! Sub-Saturday. The contractor says he's become your biggest fan. He's glad you've done so well in the arena.
We have more money
can
than I
show you some of our new potions?
Than I need right now. I might as well spend it on something, but yeah. Good stuff, my friend. Glad you made it. 12 days of Christmas soon to come. What should we get here? We're gonna get things that are generally useful, but there's so many specific things here. Don't know. Invisibility. There's a lot of interesting stuff. Yeah, well, check it out. It came out actually earlier this month. I didn't realize when it came out, but it's pretty interesting. Oh, yeah. Yeah, it was on a little, earlier streams, like they showed it for the beta or such. I tried playing my old computer, it had like 5 FPS, so I'm really excited to play it properly now. Real computer. Spell turning, yeah, a lot of these are specific. Damage, what does this do? Charge abilities. Ring of Energy. The Victor, crafted by Drow Mages of the Underdark, this weapon was used in an arranged battle between two rebel houses. Yeah, I remember that one. It shoots the little missile. Didn't I already have that though? The slave ring that they all have to wear. There it is. Yeah, he has the Victor extra explosive ring of the princes. Good stuff too. Should end the cheer, Noble. Lovely stuff for the ghost and other stuff. Alrighty, enjoy your winter stuff and DVD. Well, sounds like fun. Is the event already up? I haven't checked out the newest chapter yet. I just saw it on other streams and such, but not playing too much this year. I played it a lot the first 5 years, closed beta and such. And Ace released on my birthday, and also, yeah, we'll play sometime if you'd like, Noble. Appreciate you, good friend. Stream of fun. See you are offline and stream, but I'll still show you that good love. That's Steam stream. So thank you very much. Gotta be awesome stuff. Carry on for the things. For that lovely raid of 4. And for your chat tonight. Makes it all a wonderful experience. A wonderful time. Had a great
Yes.
Adventure. Alright, I'm gonna buy a few other miscellaneous things here. Some darts here. Imloth, my main character, been stuck in the booth here, you can see. It's pretty weird. Oh, there she is. Ignoble. Him, her, don't mind the pronouns. Okay. Oh, the Quiver of Plenty. Unlimited plus one arrows. That's generally useful. It's nice to get these new things like that. And then bolts as well. 27,000. Kind of might as well. But Sunstone Bullet. That's interesting. That's for the sling. We have fire enemies this next one specifically, so. Sling bullets. Let me get some good darts. Oh, Asp's Nest. Poison damage, that could be fun. Let's get a good 50 of those. For 10,000, holy smoke. Good thing I have some dart proficiencies. Main character here. Oh yeah, those are some pricey ones. I don't think anyone else can really use darts, so. Let me check that again. Dart proficiency for Emeloth, main Blackguard. She has short bow, he has crossbow, and she has sling, so. Yeah, I'll just keep extra ones for her. Maybe these will be worth it, maybe not. Let's get some fire resistance before I forget.
I'm on it.
We are up against fire enemies next. So we need some fire resistance for the party. Excellent. Those around. Inventory fun. Alright, we'll drink that, lasting for 2 hours. Should be plenty of time for the battle. We got an extra 5,000 now. Oh, level up on Ashia, our second character here. Got proficiencies I don't really need, but you still have to use them. We'll do more hide in shadows. There could be traps in the arena too, but hide in shadows is the generally useful, and illusions, but oh well. Alright, so I have to do a proficiency now. What should I do for her? I could do that club, I guess. There's no plus one clubs, though. Does that count for maces? Weapon class allows the character to use clubs. Are maces separate, or is that included in club? It's not telling me. We have the single weapon style, so that is good. Yeah, I got tired of that TBD grind, but still fun. Get to see that new map soon enough. Alright, thank you again, Noble, for the raid. Lovely cheer. Got it in the tip jar. Empty that tomorrow, so enjoy one more day, one more evening of this full tip jar, guys, for Birthday Champion 3 hype. We'll be finally emptying that out tomorrow. Be lovely stuff. Alright, so what else would be good for Ashia here? Just other kind, I guess. I think, yeah, club is maces. Don't see anything for mace, so. Well, she can't use maces, never mind. No wonder it's not there, she can't use them. So, she does have katana, I did extra short sword, katana. Could do another range, I guess, but the short bow already have plenty of arrows and such, so. I guess I'll just do two-handed weapon style in case. She can't really use much as a thief, she's the shadow dancer, so. So I'll do katana and scimitar, whatever. Just have a lot of options for her. Doesn't make too much difference. Alright. We had that recent hard save. Should we do another one? Let's see. Let's do another one after ice for the ice salamanders, and now we're on to some fire, so. I think that's good for now. Save a little extra money here. Doesn't hurt. Maybe she gets some ice arrows for her, but arrows plus two, pretty good, I think. Arrows plus two. What and the poison, it? I would think, would be good against fire enemies. So I'll anticipate that. I could get some better bolts for him, though. bolts of biting will help a little bit.
Salted.
Let me get a few extra for him since I do have that extra money. And we want to, ooh, lightning could be good. But this one is good bleed damage. Doesn't hurt, you know. Alright, 10 shots on that.
Yes.
And let's get started. Indeed. All right, here we go.
Spitting out.
I'm on it.
Ah, you have returned!
Are you ready to spill blood on the arena floor?
Here we go. Next up, quick saved and good to go. Check it out. Alright, just a really quick alt tab. I'm not gonna do that anymore. There we go. Friday Fables. Noble for the ring.
From the plane of fire, and mine is here. I'm even having a little trouble keeping this one in check. Begin the battle before this big belligerent breaks loose.
Let's see, the giant, he just has fire that I didn't know about. Let's see. Could be that giant we've been seeing trying to break out. Yep, there he is. And some extra fire elementals. Just because. Alright, shoot him with some bleeding, then I'll probably try to. Oh shit, I didn't take the fire potion.
Yes.
Time for that then. Hopefully it's quick, because, yeah, there we go.
It's fine.
All right, so one for him.
What is it?
Bleed him a bit, your poison concern? Him. Try to knock these
These
two down also. All right, we'll see how this plays out. Here's the big boy, Hogaro. It's time to fight. Poison him up a bit. There we go.
What?
That'll help.
Yes.
Aura of Despair, take it forever and a day, sadly. Charm person, I don't think that would work on him. Probably not. Oh man, I gotta avoid him though, he's gonna hit like a truck, you know. Oh god. We're closing in.
Go on, man.
Skirt to the back. Ah! He shakes the whole screen. Look at that. Oh no, they slept him? How did they slip him? He knocked him unconscious. Instantly. Oh god. It's like a truck indeed.
What is it?
Shadow step the heck out of here. Might want to take that potion of freedom.
Fine.
Could be helpful. Whew. Oh, they're back up. They're back up.
Salt.
I am here.
Get out while you can. Fire elemental is immune. Jeez. What's she doing here?
Your concern?
Don't do it.
Indeed.
Don't do that. Squishy mage not looking like a good,
you right.
Good spot there. He's missing his shots on the giant. I mean, he's a gnome.
Yes.
Oh, shit. She's still up there. Yeah. Ouch.
Yes.
Indeed. Wow, can you shake the screen a little more?
Such menial tasks. I am here.
Knocked him down again. Just like what randomly puts someone to sleep when he does that.
Your concern. It is done.
Not a good spot. Yeah, switch targets. I cannot attack. Weapon ineffective. So now we know. Fire elemental is also resistance to slashing damage somehow.
What is it?
I don't know how that is possible, but.
Yes?
Go on then.
Use his ring. That might help.
Yes.
Yep, his piercing damage did work. Oh, shoot. He's Using the ring.
What?
You know, slashing damage does not work.
What is it? Fine.
Let me try the darts. Some expensive darts to theorize with. Holy God. Critical miss. Doesn't help. Smashing him, yeah, nothing I can do.
Yes.
So the arrows work, the magic arrows, and the piercing work. Why do they have so much health though? So much damage. These are insane challenges. At least this is more fun than the golems. I was really hating the game for that.
Fine.
This is all challenging, but at least I know I can do it. At least I know it's possible.
Oh. What is it? A simple matter?
I just can't resist, can't. How am I missing the giant freaking target?
What?
Let's see, the potion of freedom didn't last. Poisoning him up.
Such menial tasks. Yes, such menial tasks.
Trying to stay alive. Can't even heal, because they're... Yep, she's dead. Just a moth. Fight to the end, but... Ugh. Oh, they keep knocking us down. The ground slam, man. There's no chance yet. That was interesting, but yeah, now we know. And keep in mind, all this game so far has been on easy mode, guys. Literally easy mode. It's not the easiest of story mode. We just can't die, but God. That's good for now. We had a fun time. We left off a good point there to overcome that. We just need something to stay alive from that sleeping insanity, so. Wow. Good for now. Let's move on. Something else a bit fun here for tonight. Let's see what else we got. I don't think I'll do that quick play Wellspring weekly for Hunt this time. Oh, yeah, we got Bone Chill on DVD. I didn't see that update. Didn't really notice it, so. We'll try that out soon. It's December 9th, yesterday to December 23rd, so before Christmas Eve. Have a solid couple weeks for that. Alrighty, let's see what's next here, guys. Maybe some Styx. I'll save that Dishonor for soon. I want to try out Styx, Master of Shadows. I think that would be good fun for the time being. So, can switch over to some of that. Check it out. Have a good time moving forward. So, 1 second, I'll get into a bit of that. Good progress on Black Pits for now, but it's quite the challenge. Alright, well, we'll be set here, guys. Lovely stuff. Thanks again one more time, at least once more. Nova Vampire for that lovely raid. Get our chat started for the night. That is very exciting and good fun. And do appreciate it. Pretty awesome. Alright, back in just 1 sec. Keep it going. Keep it rolling, and we'll be great fun. Absolutely, guys. Another lovely stuff. Alright, 1 minute. We'll keep it rolling here tonight. Get to a new fun game. This one came before Shards of Darkness, so I wanted to play them in order. So I was having a tough time, Shards of Darkness. Maybe now we can learn a bit from that. Maybe we'll play of Orcs and Men again at some point, but this one is a good one to try for now. So let's try it out. Back in a second. And on we go. Alrighty, frames holding pretty steady for now. Let's try this out, guys. See how some fun Styx goes. Maybe we'll get some better progress than the first one. That should be fun. Alright. Shard the Darkness before. It's time for Master of Shadows. Right now. Let's try it out and have a great time. Okay, okay. Get some pinball next time. Hopefully a bit of that tomorrow. Where's my pinball? Where's my pinball? There we go. Gotta have my pinball. Lose fun. Alright, try this out. A nice time. Alright. Well, look at that resolution. Yeah. Another game that can't handle display capture. Alright, that's for sure. Let's turn that off right now. Okay. That should be better. Alright, we switched over. Looking good, looking good. There we go. Alright. Press a button. Good old one from 2014. So we can learn the stealth style a bit better, because we're having a tough time Shards of Darkness there. This one should be a little bit easier to pick it up earlier in the progress. Goblin. For a player who likes a realistic challenge, enemies detect you faster, and in melee combat they can kill you with one hit. Projectiles inflict significant damage. No thanks. Serious challenge. Detect you faster, damage they inflict is increased. Experienced player default settings. Since I'm really having a hard time just getting the basic stuff of this, I think easy actually would be fine. Yeah. I mean, you can't really fight in this one. It's just basically full stealth, so. Go ahead and start off there. Maybe we can do a second playthrough someday, but yeah. Let's go ahead and do the basic mode for now. Won't feel any like a challenge for that, because I'm just used to more combat, straightforward, not just constant stealth, so it'd be good for some good skills in that. Let's not overly challenge yourself. It'll be more fun that way. You can do other good challenges down the line. Games we get familiar with, games we feel like we're confident enough to really take on the full blast. But did Dishonored 2 on hard, so that was good. High chaos, though. Easier, low chaos. But I did enjoy both of them back in the day. So not too fun. Get to Death of the Outsider very shortly here. Hopefully this coming week. Get a noble vampire, lovely raid, and chats. Got that party fun stuff. And the last night for this full tip jar, guys. We had some lovely birthday champions so far. So we can keep it going for the rest of Subathon. Very first Subathon. As we go on to a great week ahead and great weekend. Just beginning. Good rehearsal in the morning. Get some good Messiah Sunday night. I got a party to go to actually tomorrow evening too, so see if we can do a little streaming in the afternoon. But I always confusing things. I schedule when I have things otherwise for the party, so.
The atrium of Akanash. A world shut inside another. This is what humans do when they don't understand a thing. They build walls around it. They put locks on the doors, and they put soldiers in front of those doors. The bigger the secret, the bigger the lock. And the craziest are those who want to pick it. May my ancestors forgive me. I'm one of those, to my misfortune. Ah, this noise. These voices. I can't stand it. Amber. That damn golden mud oozing from the heart of the world tree. A magma of sticky dreams. All the thoughts of those who wanted to taste the forbidden sap. Humans. Elves. All their private little chatters mixed up in this disgusting soup. A flood of ideas constantly flowing into my head. For all these years, it took so long for me to find this place. With each step, I heard my voice a little less, and all the others a little more. I'm so tired. It's time to finish it. While I can still recognize my own thoughts. The heart of the tree, it's why I'm here. That, at least, I am sure is my own desire. Take possession
of this source of infinite power, but also misfortune. It's time to move to the first phase of the plan.
Drop your weapon.
And it starts now.
Alright, beast. Wake up. Answer when Lord Barnum speaks to you.
Who are you? Speak.
My name is Styx.
There's a surprise. The elves give names to their monsters.
Where do you come from? I've never seen anything that looks like you.
I am one of a kind.
It's the elves who created it, Father, that's obvious. They pulled this runt out of their sticky larvae, and they sent it here to spy on us.
Speak! Is it the elves who sent you? Why are you here?
Elves. If you only knew. They don't need spies to find out what's going on in this accursed tower.
So, you're working for them. What did you come here for?
I came for the heart of the tree, of course.
I knew it. Those degenerates want to retake the tree and keep their precious amber for themselves. Father, we must bring them to heel while we still have time.
Enough, Aaron. I secured this alliance with the elves and I intend to respect it. For the moment, we need the elves. You know it very well.
Rubbish.
Oh yes, you do need the elves. How many of you poor little humans died the last time you tried to extract amber by yourselves, huh? How many? Hundreds? Oh yes, you do need the elves. But they don't need you. How long do you think you can lock them up in their own world? The amber is theirs. The tree is theirs. The heart of the tree is theirs. And I intend to get my hands on it and take it away from here.
They're dying to get their tree back, eh? But they won't do a thing. We have an agreement.
An agreement? We don't sign agreements with people who have amber in their veins. You're out of your depth, Mr. Governor.
Oh, you've got some nerve. I'm sure you've never even seen the heart of the tree.
Oh, but I have seen it. Since I've been holed up in the bowels of the atrium, I can see it night and day, even in my dreams. And every day I say to myself, hey, Rakash, the heart of the tree is over there, almost within reach. And by your life, you're gonna find some way to steal it, because you're not leaving the tower without it. Trees.
Yeah. Oh, this headache. What? Where was I? Shit, my brain is an anvil. Yeah. The heart of the tree. What did I do with my dagger? I feel naked without my dagger. I gotta find it quick.
C and F, yeah. Control those things. Just to control, let's see what it does. Yep, nothing, so we can actually switch it to there. Make noise. Yeah, that'll be better. Great. Very agile, you can jump and hang on. Still was dying along the next game.
Climb up there.
Falling off the map, though.
Did you see the dagger that Duncan found? I wonder where it comes from. It's not from here.
Yeah, well, don't get excited. We'll play for it with dice tonight. In the meantime, keep your hands off.
Okay. I'll wait till tonight.
But they won't.
They must be talking about my dagger. It can't be far away.
I should drink this flask. Perk me up a little.
Along your way, you will encounter vials of life, such as this one. Plenish your health god. Start with half health, because he was in prison.
Well, more climbing, I guess.
The lateral Tomb Raider movement looks fun. Unable to defend yourself, you must avoid being detected until you find your dog. Alright.
I must stay out of sight until I find my dagger.
Master of the Shadows. The more you stay in the dark, the less chance. Awareness bar. Enemies may notice.
Always keep to the shadows.
Alright, that's that. It is tough. I mean, I'm not used to this amount of stealth, you know, style, so it's a good challenging game. It'll be good for me just to learn that, I guess. Yeah, it is tough, though. Definitely a lot more stealth than I'm used to. Yeah, this just makes it such a more challenging game than I'm used to. But but I'll get the hang of it. It'll just be good for me to learn for other games that stealth is optional. This one completely mandatory. It'll hopefully teach me some good skills for this style. And it's pretty good design, I guess. I won't refund it after all.
Always keep to the shadows. Walk where it doesn't make too much noise. Avoid running and farting.
Understood.
This guy. Wow. Alright, where is Quicksave? No Quicksave. Oh yeah, F5 does work. Okay. No clones or anything yet, so I'll worry about that. At least save here at the door. Should be good.
Always keep to the shadows. Walk where it doesn't make too much noise. Avoid running and farting.
That's better.
To what I heard, the only access to the heart
is a bridge which that two-faced Governor Baron has had closed off with a tamper-proof lock. And he keeps the only key in his apartments. And as if that wasn't bad enough, the whole area is crawling with elves. I'm gonna have to go down into the prisons and free my friend. So, if I'm gonna survive in this tower, I'm gonna need somewhere safe to get organized, as well as a map of the atrium. Well, I'll get nothing done standing around here. I'll get my dagger, and it's off to work.
Alright. See about that. We shall certainly see. Fable, come back for the lurk. Few raiders from Noble Vampire. You guys doing well tonight? On a fun Friday. That it is. Pretty cold here. We're actually expecting snow next week, so. More snow streams. Smaller size. Enemies see you high, they may investigate or call. Basic enough gameplay, but still pretty challenging for me. Requires a lot of patience.
Ah, there's my dagger. I was afraid that I lost you, my beauty.
What was that noise? Stop!
Let's see. We got maps in the area.
You can leave a box of like that on the map to get what I want.
Under there, thankfully. Knocking over the bucket and all. Anything that can go around this game, I feel like I probably will. It's too easy to mess up. I don't know how to hang on ledges. That should be so simple. But it just doesn't work for me. Think of all these other games' controls, this one is definitely unique. Alert someone, doesn't matter. So I just wanted to hang on a ledge. He can't do that. He has to actually get to the ledge. It's weird.
Assassin's rule number one. Always strike from behind. Especially when the fucker is twice your size. And remember to land on the carpet to make less noise.
Guards attack in melee combat, you're locked in and must repel their attacks. Pair their attacks with the proper timing and kill them when they're off balance. It's a good challenge, it's a new style of game, you know, I never played Orcs and Men, was more like strategic, didn't really have much stealth to it, but right. Still pretty challenging.
Let's keep going.
Play that again at some point. I guess his body doesn't matter.
What's going on over there?
That didn't last long.
Sand? A little spit? I could put that torch out from here.
chain EQ. It's Q.
Look up there. Show yourself. What?
That was lucky. That was very lucky. Alright, so just a couple hits. Shift, what is shift do? Just a sprint, of course, but just walks, which is very weird. It's actually slower than stealth crouching. Just walk. Oh, man. Some weird controls this game. Weird nuances.
Shit, more guards. Stay hidden behind this barrel, it should be fine.
Inch your way over. Pretty interesting. Pretty difficult. Look how convenient that was. Oh, never mind. Keep it straightforward for now. I don't need to try to mess around. Oh, could have gone in here. Where's this go? Just a hiding spot. Alright. Good for now. So this is an alternate to sneaking, but it's so much slower. I guess you should only use it when you really want to go slow. Or you can do this. Slower. Double slow. Interesting. Alright, this is weird.
What the hell is
that? I'm really not used to left click being parry. I'm so much more used to right click. Timing is really hard, of course. Challenging stuff. Skill points allow you to learn new skills. The objective succeeded. Not very well, but get out of here. Cave, other side objectives. Wow. That's pretty tough.
Oh my god. I gotta get me some armor. Yeah. That'll straighten you out.
Amber addict.
Down there, maybe?
It's a pretty cool animation, though.
The England to study these cocoons more closely, it would be fascinating.
Quite so, my dear colleague. I'd be willing to give my complete edition of the Encyclopedia of Mycology for the right to dissect one.
You're telling me? Hey, when...
I'm sure I...
A quick peek through the keyhole just to make sure the way is clear.
No chance.
remember. I gotta get some now. My head is gonna explode.
Let's fix that.
No choice. I'll need some help. Hello, Rackash. I need your run carcass. Damn, I hate it.
It's a limited life. Oops. Invisibility. These extra things, yeah, just be lucky to get through it, get maybe some of the achievements. I don't know. This is hard. 33 achievements.
We'll see. Shit! A sliding grill. I'm stuck. This is impossible. There's got to be a way.
Just on my amber power. Too quickly.
Somebody there?
That was Styx. Ah, look at that.
Hey, Styx! Over here!
What? What do you want?
It's Ozcan. I'll open the passage for you. Hurry up inside! Huh? Ozcan? Oh, my head. Yeah, I know that name. Ozcan. Yes, you can trust him. Anyway, you don't have a choice.
About time, Styx. I've been waiting for ages. I was beginning to wonder if Barryman and his gang hadn't done you in.
There was a slight hitch. Well, I think so. My head feels like a wagon's gone through. Well, we'll take care of that later. What are you doing here?
Well, I'm here to tell you that I found a hideout, like you asked me to.
I asked you? Yeah, of course I asked you. Damn this headache. It must be why I can't remember what I did even yesterday. Good. I'm off to the hideout then. You'll tell me the way?
All you have to do is follow the marks I made here and there. You'll see. This is my personal system.
As soon as you see the mark, then you know that one of my hiding places is near. You can go inside. There's one close by, with, as it happens, a list of other hiding places. You'll see. I'll... inside.
Thanks. I'm off.
Whoa, 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 wait! You'll have to pick up the sewer pry bar in another hiding place. Oh, yeah, one thing I didn't tell you. The hideout is in the, sewers. But you know how it is. The more it smells like shit, the quieter it is. You'll fit right in.
And to think I was beginning to like you.
Sorry to disappoint you, but with your looks, it's best not to take risks. And anyway, the wrong swim's already taken. In short, go on ahead, pick up the pry bar, and open the entrance to the sewers. I'll see you at the hideout.
Well, well. Looks like Ozcan carries a flask in his belt. Let's hope I haven't lost my touch.
Alrighty. Let's get good there. All looking set. Maybe 1 minute we carry on. Let's see what else here for tonight. Carry this on, or maybe get to a round of hunt. We'll see. Give me a sec. All right, a little bit more of this, and get in a round of hunt. Just for the fun of it.
I could easily find these marks with my amber vision.
Oh, look at that. Marking. Who's that?
Beat it, old man. Oh, watch out, Styx. After what I did for you, you better keep your tongue behind your teeth.
What? What did you do for me?
I gave you the plans that will take you to the relics of the atrium. That cost me this fucking amber scar on my face. Besides,
one shouldn't go too far.
The relics of the atrium?
You kidding me, Styx? Yes, the relics, the last objects of the great fallen lords.
Yeah, of course it rings a bell.
Yeah, well, good luck. I paid enough for this shit and all your schemes.
I should keep my eyes peeled. These relics must be pretty valuable.
Some book. And you can't pick it out of him, so better use them sparingly. Once you use it, it is used. there's something up there. Assassinations like Dishonored. Yeah, pretty tough. Alright, back to it soon, then we'll learn a bit more, but yeah, we have to be very much more skilled in that than regularly. But hey, we got a trading card. So that was fun. Keep it up, back to that soon. Let's just get in a little round of hunt here. Gonna go ahead and export those VODs off stream. We'll be back to it sub Saturday tomorrow on a can, guys. Afternoon before heading out. So we shall see. That will be good. And I will see you then. Get some little export VODs. Let's just play a little round for now for the fun of it. Back to it just a little bit. Okay. Pretty challenging there. Few screenshots and such. There was the other one, yeah. All that stuff. Oh, you can't see it there. Whoops. Just look at it real quick. Yep, saw the other one. A few enhancements and one tonight. Not the greatest screenshots lately. Oh well. Alrighty. Good to go for now. Left off here. Wow, sound is really low. Play more hunts soon. Looking forward to it. Got several things in the mix. Good prestige. All these guys. Get that sniper Scosmith, can afford a few centennials. Oh, there's one. Just buy that thing. Why not? Play him for tonight. Try. Got a daily from 5 minutes. Last round, yeah. So I did quick play, yeah. That's what that was. So don't worry about that. 11 more wellsprings, 2 days. No, that's right. Kill 3 spiders for a rifle. Don't worry about that either. Let's just have the good fun one for now. And we shall finish our emulators waiting soon as well. Good stuff. Just a quick little one here. See how George Nordahl does. Nice new model, though. Didn't we've seen that before. Cowboy hat. Get a little Centennial XP if I can. Try them out. Play another day soon. That's the plan. Play more in a bit will be great. Alrighty. It's the one and done for now, I think. Cool cowboy. Cowboy hat. Getting my centennial sniper. Getting pretty close here. Get that 4 prestige. Let's get a couple of these sniper scopesmith. I can use that. Save rest of my money for the legendary hunters, probably. Get some cool ones like that. Yeah, like the new one coming out. Outlaw. Lawless is similar to that model we saw there, so take a look at that next time. Check it out a bit more. Century Age of Ashes. Tonight's another good fun like that. That'll be great, guys. Yeah, I'm seeing it's pretty similar with the glasses. Pretty cool. Alright. Nice little round here. We'll play more tomorrow. See their schedule. Good fun, less crazy madness. Random Discord partners, another spot. That'll be fun. I've not been playing with speakers lately, but I think we'll be fine just for this one round. So, let's see how it goes. So, give me a little Centennial XP. And go from there. Just sell. Alright, small bounty to sell. Try it out, guys. Shall certainly try it out. Oh, that is bright. Edge of the map. Nice and bright. Oh, a little bit of lag here. Clears up. There it is. Alright, edge of the map here. Let me see just how far it goes. Fuck that. Can also see down there pretty well. That's a good vantage point. Hey, look at that. Gives me the whole angle. If we had sniper, this would be a really good. The entire south near Moses. Pretty impressive. I could go for that clue, or I could go for King Snake. I don't know why the switching is so laggy. It gets me killed because you can't switch fast enough. It's a little slow. Yeah. Rub. Should have just shot at that point. Yep, that is a waste. That's a bit of a waste. Yeah. Ugh. Hives are the worst. Definitely least favorite would be those hives. Ugh. Gotta shoot them. Get used to the lag again and such. It is lag. I got some good experience though, so that did help. I almost got it. Wanted to buy her, but not in the picture now. No chance now. And that sniper I could have just bought too. Oh well. That is that. But there, the frag, everything else. Not get the chance to. I'll do one more quick one then, because that was just a little disastrous. The bleed and poison damage, not a good mix. The bleed is what really killed me, but hive came quick. And stamina, yeah, stamina is also tricky. Well, that was that. Fortunate end to that good potential hunter, yeah. Monsters. Hive has definitely always been my worst, though, so. Yeah. Can't understand. I mean, I died early to Hellhounds, too, and I had the bounty and such, you know. It happens. It just happens sometimes. Cannot fight it out sometimes. Sometimes I'm reserving shooting because I didn't want to. But just didn't work out, so. Added to the game's toll. Probably no one will find my body either, but that's how it goes. At least get really close to that centennial, so I'll be able to use a few snipers. Hopefully get a few lucky legendary hunters with that snipers. So Smith, but I was hoping to prestige actually after the Halloween event, so I'll do it before the Christmas event. At least have some time. See how it looks. Oh man. Solo spider. Blue shade just kicked on, so yeah, I'll finish with this, either case. Just to play a little more, though. A nice scenery. Too bad everyone trying to kill each other, huh? VoIP not exactly likely to convince them to be peaceful. People just go crazy. In my experience. Binge on the high would be nice. Thank you. shooting still. Can't really tell. Well, I'm good to sell, so that's fine. Bloody hard to tell where stuff comes from. Maybe Darren. I feel better with headphones, so yeah, probably last time I played with speakers. Just for the experience of it. Come back here. Too likely to work. Where he got to? So difficult to track people. He knows I'm there. Why he's so accurate, but yep. Get back to it soon. That is ridiculous. Pretty ridiculous. Pretty annoying, frustrating. Alright, tune a bit, guys. Sorry, can I get some better action for you tonight? But we'll pick it up soon. We've made some good Black Pits progress, nothing else. Back to it in a bit. I've got to get ahead and get this export shortly. We'll come back. Sub Saturday. Have some other things. Stupid stuff and hunt, you know, sometimes. But we'll pick it up. Be better in a bit. Oh well. Catch you then, guys. We'll be fine. Thanks again, Noble Vampire, for the raid. Sorry for chat. Thank you, Fabelot, for lurking. Catch you soon. We'll be fine. And we'll be back. Thanks to the bits as well. Thank you. And catch you soon. Good games. Oh. Catch you then, guys. We'll be fine. Thanks again, Noble Vampire, for the raid. Sorry for chat. Thank you, Fabelot, for lurking. Catch you soon. We'll be fine. We'll be back. Thanks to the bits as well.